With all of its unknowns.
Why don't we just go ahead and tell her that we're divorcing?
My daughter is not a weapon.
Take him away.
The fate of the free-thinking world is in your hands.
I know you've been meeting with her behind my back.
It's not what you think, Mac.
I'm talking to you!
Right here in life.
As
you just I sense suffering here, Spirit.
You have to work on it. You can't just give up.
We're never getting out of here.
Let's see how special you are.
I have been doomed to a life of solitude.
Rule with strength, but understand suffering.
It will not be fine. It will be fantastico!
I guess it's my time to shine.
God gives victory to the lions. When I look into your eyes, I see lions.
Sorry, could you repeat that?
After him! Now!
Do you feel it?
Yes. You want to stay a team?
You feel it?
Yes.
Enjoy the beach.
One revolution was enough.
I'm breaking this loop.
Welcome to the Game Awards 2021. Now, here's your host, Jeff Keighley.
Hello, everybody. We're here. We made it. Hello, everyone. I'm Jeff Keighley, and this is the Game Awards, video games' biggest night, live in person. It's amazing. First of all, wasn't Sting phenomenal? So honored to have him open our show. That was What Could Have Been from Arcane, the new Netflix series based on League of Legends. Thank you so much, Sting, Ray Chen, and the Game Awards Orchestra, conducted by Lauren Balfe. That was absolutely incredible. Thank you, guys. Well, I gotta say, it feels so incredible to be back here on stage at Microsoft Theater and streaming live to tens of millions of you around the world. This is a night for the fans, and you know, the games we love are nothing without amazing games. We love are nothing without amazing Games we love are nothing without...
El audio se fue la mierda. Bla, 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 bla.
Thing without...
El audio se fue la mierda. Ahora es cuando se va a escuchar. Bla, 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 bla. Se escucha
thing
bien.
Without...
El audio se fue la mierda. Ahora la música está sonando. Mierda, debe haber hecho esto antes. Pero no sé, me había olvidado crear los Game Awards. Ahora la música está sonando. Mierda, debe haber hecho esto antes. Pero no sé, me había olvidado crear los Game Awards. Ahora la música está sonando. Mierda, debe haber hecho esto antes. Vale, no se escucha. Todo está bien.
Greater and more inclusive future. The games we play, and when the games that we love, they teach us that we can impact the world around us. And tonight, I call on everyone to do their part to build a better, safer video game industry. Speak out online, vote with your time and with your dollars. Empower these world builders who are creating the future of all entertainment. And believe me, the future you're about to see looks absolutely incredible. We got a lot of good stuff for you. We have so much news to get to. But now, to present tonight's first award, please welcome a nominee tonight and the star of Far Cry 6, the one and only Giancarlo Esposito!
Independence allows a game to go a little bit more wild, become a bit stranger, and the freedom to break boundaries. Tonight's radically creative nominees for Best Independent Game demonstrate excellence achieved through great risk. Here are the nominees for Best Independent Game.
Best Independent Game.
Look, I know this sounds weird, but the day's repeating itself.
And the Game Award for Best Independent Game goes to Kena, Bridge of Spirits.
Kena, Bridge of Spirits also wins Best Debut Indie Game.
Well, yeah, you know, it was an amazing journey to get here. It took a lot of hard work from an awesome team. A few of them are here today, but just can't say enough about the amazing people we worked with on to make this game and to make the vision come true. Have to thank our partners at Sony, who kind of believed in us from the very beginning, gave us a great opportunity, and all the guys at Epic who just have been there from the beginning. So thank you, everyone, and this is a great honor. Thank you.
Awesome. Congratulations, guys. All right, now it's time to look into the future. 2 years ago, this team announced their game on this very stage. Now they're back with the first gameplay reveal. When I saw this, I could not believe it was actual gameplay, but it is captured by the team in-game this past weekend. Sit back and get ready to experience a new level of cinematic immersion.
And she said, with our swords, we will forge new stories to strike the gods that haunt us. You might see me as weak, but I will show you what lies behind my eyes.
Oh,
embrace our suffering, soothe our scars of grief, and break their siege of our minds. You may see them as gods, but we will show you what lies behind their eyes.
Listen. It's coming.
He's here.
That's my name. He can smell your fear.
Sisu.
It knows our name.
How does it know my name?
To risk your own life for what you believe is your sacrifice to make. To lead others to death brings a different kind of burden.
Skimply.
One that Senua would have to learn to bear.
Joy. Vardna.
Smell their fear.
There is no death.
He's here. Death is coming.
Look at the bones.
Death is coming.
Look at the bones. That's going to be you. That's going to be everyone. No one's ever killed a giant. What makes you think you can
stay down?
Those whose eyes are clouded by fear are besieged by the ghosts that haunt them. Senua saw that to win the war, we must break this siege. Break it with an unshakable truth. Break it with an impossible feat.
Senua, get ready. It's about to start.
They can
fire.
Get ready. What's your name?
I know you.
He needs you.
Un spoiler. Salen gigantes en el juego.
Truly incredible. That's not a cinematic, that's gameplay, and that's why we do world premieres, because the state of our art just keeps getting better. Thanks to Ninja Theory for that incredible piece. And now, it's time for our first of many brand new game announcements at the Game Awards. I hope you're ready.
Kojima. Este es el Star Wars. El que anunciaron el... ¿Cómo se llama? Que según es buenísimo. Es una continuación de lo que... en el espacio. No sé si se ve en la lista. Se supone que solo es para la pantalla. Eso me está comiendo la rutina.
What a way to kick off our game announcement. Star Wars Eclipse will be the first game set in the High Republic era of the Star Wars galaxy, and it is being created by Quantic Dream in collaboration with Lucasfilm Games and is currently in early development. All right, there are many more game announcements to come, trust me, as well as awards. All night we are partnering with YouTube Shorts. If you have a favorite nominee tonight that doesn't win, let us know your thoughts by posting a YouTube Short with the hashtag GotShorted and head to the YouTube Gaming Twitter handle to find out how to get your very own salty consolation gift. All right, right now it's time to meet our first global gaming citizen, a program we started back in 2018 to turn our air over to individuals who are building positive, inclusive communities around gaming. We're honored to share their stories.
I grew up playing games. Games was as a little kid, as a little gay boy, not knowing why I'm so different. Games gave me a place to feel safe and to be myself.
Foi uma espécie de escape. Quando eu encontrei os jogos, quando eu comecei a jogar, eu acabei criando ali o meu espaço, sabe? Criando ali o meu mundo.
It gave me a reference to be inspired, to build up all this drag, this insane costume, all this makeup, all this hair, but feel powerful. Because as a kid, I felt weak. I felt like the outsider.
Foi daí que eu conheci o serviço de streaming e eu senti muito essa necessidade de atribuir para minha comunidade coisas que eu não via, sabe? Essa visibilidade. Eu não me enxergava nas coisas que eu assistia. Eu como uma pessoa LGBT.
Now let's run to the exit. When you find people that have similar interests, you can be yourself.
Yes. So close.
You don't have to be worried about all these things that make you different. They can be what make you special.
Hi folks, Pete Hines here. Yeah, we've got some stuff on sale, but let's all take a breather while we give away hundreds of free game codes. This is our small way of saying thank you for playing our games for the past 35 years. And we're just getting started. From Ghostwire to Redfall to Starfield and much more, including stuff that hasn't even leaked yet. So if you can't imagine doing anything other than developing and publishing games with us, we have a project that can use your talents. In fact, across Bethesda and all our studios, we're hiring. So consider this your invitation to join us. There's a lot of work to be done, and we're running out of platforms to port Skyrim to. And because it's not simple to give anything away for free these days, here's a bunch of legal text.
No me salió yo, por favor. ¿Qué?
Is the foolish dream of mortals.
Esperen que están confiados todos.
But this world, this
es que Amnesia,
tío, is more dangerous than you could ever imagine.
No, este código de canción que es de los cabrones asquerosos.
Once again, the chaos gates have burst open. The demon legions of Kassaros blot out the sun. Do not give in. There's still one chance to end this madness. Find the Ark before all is lost.
Conduz. February 11 hasta febrero, jugadores. Bueno, pues aún no puedo jugar. Con cosas que hacer. Podría haber ocasión.
That was a new look at Lost Ark from Amazon Games coming in February. And speaking of Amazon, we're proud to partner with Prime Gaming on the Game Awards. This month, you can level up your gaming experience with free games, including Need for Speed, Hot Pursuit, Tales of Monkey Island, and Frostpunk. There's always something new to play every month. And for the games you already own, you can unlock skins, weapons, and more, including in League of Legends, New World, Apex Legends, and Roblox. Check regularly for new drops and surprises at gaming.amazon.com. Next, in the days leading into the Game Awards, I read the internet with a little bit of fear, wondering if some of tonight's big surprises might leak. This one sure didn't. It's time for a new game announcement that no one had on their bingo card. Enjoy.
My daughter, a new threat comes to our shores, and I must call you home. Restore what has been broken. Unite old enemies. Forge new bonds. You are a hero. But you can be more. You can be a leader. You are Wonder Woman.
Who portrayed Ellie and Abby in The Last of Us Part 2. Please welcome Ashley Johnson and Laura Bailey.
Hi! Every year, the Best Performance category brings surprising new faces and portrayals of wildly different characters. Tonight's nominated actors continue this tradition, once again stunning us with their extraordinary depth and dedication. Here are the nominees for Best Performance.
Best Performance.
I see the truth about you. I've seen the worst parts of you.
To rebuild paradise, the cost will be blood.
Eight geniuses who painted up a prison and named it freedom.
You escaped my little brother's idiot games, did you?
Everybody chose to be your cult.
Don't hide your true self!
The Game Award for Best Performance goes to Maggie Robertson.
Wow, that was the scariest walk I've ever done in my life. Thank you so much. It is an honor to receive this award, and it is an honor to be standing here in front of you all today. I would like to give a really huge thank you to Capcom for creating an amazing game full of wonderfully rich and dynamic characters, of which Lady D is but one. And to Rosanna and DJ with The Workhouse, to Steve Knibley, our amazing cinematics director. I've said this before, but I'm going to say it again because I'm a broken record. You took a chance on me when you hired me for this role, and in doing so, you have changed my life. Being a part of this game, playing this role, and becoming a member of this amazing community has changed my life. So thank you so, so much.
We all come to a story with hopes and expectations, looking for an answer. Sometimes it would be better to live with that hope, without ever finding the story. This is not the story you want it to be. This story will eat you alive. This story is a monster. And monsters wear many faces.
Dios, sí que es. Joder. Dios, pues el juego estaba. La historia estaba bastante gritada. Incluso en el miedo, pero...
Gotcha! All right, I'm joined by my man, Sam Lake. Sam, thank you for coming all the way over from Finland for this. This is so exciting. Alan Wake 2, it's been a decade. Fans have been asking you for it. Why is now the right time to bring him back?
Well, Jeff, first of all, I want to say apologies. It's been raining here in Los Angeles today. It's on us. Like fiction, fiction leaking out into reality. So sorry. Anyway, yeah, 10 years, over 10 years. Wanting to make this, dreaming of making it, we've been iterating on the concept, and we know fans have been asking for it. We've been a bit protective. We knew this is going to be a pretty scary experience. But now we are convinced everybody is ready. You are ready.
What kind of game are we going to get for the sequel? Can you tell us something about it?
Yeah, we are breaking new ground here. This is going to be Remedy's first ever survival horror game.
Ooh,
our take on the genre. Yeah. The first game had horror going to be Remedy's first ever survival horror game.
Ooh,
our take on the genre.
Yeah.
The first game.
Mierda, no se escucha mucho. Tengo que bajarle más al.
Story, horror story, is at the very heart of this, and it's psychological layered, deep mystery to dive into.
You know, you are such an incredible visionary. I can't wait to see what you're doing with this game. I know you said to me a while ago this was your dream project, and I'm so honored that we got to announce this here at the Game Awards. So we're going to hear more next year, I think, right?
Yes. We, you know, fitting to the theme,
yes.
We're going to go dark for a while to work on this.
Yeah.
We'll be back next year, summertime, to show more.
All right, summer 2022, more on Alan Wake 2. Sam, thank you so much for that announcement.
Thank you.
Very exciting. All right. Well, now I'd like to welcome a comedian, writer, and a well-known chili dog enthusiast. It's Ben Schwartz.
Sports. I played the voice of Sonic the Hedgehog in the Sonic the Hedgehog movies. Thank you. That's very kind. Thank you very much. And I just wanted to say thank you so much for supporting our movie. Also, thank you very much for the note about Sonic's legs and teeth in our original trailer. That note for real. That's a good note. That's a good note. I'm really happy that worked out. We needed that. We really needed that. The good news is, so many of you loved our first movie that we got to make a sequel. And today, yes! Video game movies, come on! Yes! Sure, two other people at the end. Today, I brought with me the trailer to that sequel. Yeah. I mean, this isn't like the real trailer. This is a blank DVD for effect. If this was the real trailer, I feel like we'd be screwed because there's no computer with a DVD drive anymore, so this would be, like, troublesome. Anyway, I can't tell you how excited we all are about Sonic 2. So many incredible people are in this movie. We got James Marsden, Tika Sumpter, Colleen O'Shaughnessy as Tails, Idris Elba as Knuckles, and, of course, the legend Jim Carrey as Dr. Robotnik. Now, Jim has actually sent a very special video over to say hello to all of you, and you guys are in luck, because I have the video with me right here. Oh, a callback! I'm happy. Just kidding. This is blank still. Let's roll the video, Jim. What do you say?
Hello, everyone, and hello, Ben. I'm sorry I couldn't be there with you, but I look forward to meeting all of your avatars in the metaverse, where we can really get to know each other. Hey, before you see this exciting new Sonic trailer, I'd like to pass on a word of advice that my Scottish grandfather gave to me when I was just a boy. He said, son, don't grate it in the grinder. Don't do it, son. Don't grate it in the grinder, boy. Grate it? By all means, grate it till the cows come home. But don't grate it in the grinder. And then to drive the point home, he put his hands around my neck and he squeezed real hard and he said, don't do it, son! Don't grate it in the grinder! Are you listening to me, boy?
Are you listening?
Wow. Yeah. Inspiring words. Thank you, Jim. You know, I think we all needed to hear that. Yeah, take it in if you need to. Good? Great. Okay, here we go. Thank you again for continuing to support the Blue Blur, and it is my honor to present to you the trailer for Sonic the Hedgehog 2. Enjoy.
Quick stretch, little snack, and here we go.
Sonic, I love that you want to help make a difference.
Mind if I drive?
But you're being reckless.
Don't worry, nobody's gonna get hurt.
Pretending to be Batman.
Blue Justice, trademark pending.
You're still just a kid.
Woohoo!
Trust me, there will come a moment when your powers will be needed. But you don't choose that moment. That moment chooses you.
I just got goosebumps. Wait a second, did you steal that from Oprah?
Papa's got a brand new stash.
Since I've been gone, I've discovered the source of ultimate power.
That sounds big. It's been on my vision board for years.
Hope I'm not too late.
I'm sorry, who are you?
Name's Tails.
Okay, this is what we're gonna do. Step one, light taunting. Step two, I have no idea. That wasn't too bad. Today's forecast calls for a 100% chance of adventure. Return to sender. Face it, you're never going to get my power.
Do I look like I need your power?
Knuckles.
Where are my manners?
Sonic, meet Knuckles.
So fun. All right. Next, one of your nominees tonight for most anticipated game is Horizon Forbidden West from Guerrilla Games. The team is hard at work back home in Amsterdam, finishing it up for a February release, but I'm grateful they put together this for the fans.
Mierda, ¿quién dijo? No le presto atención. No, Guerrilla. ¿Kojima? Los de Guerrilla. ¿Cómo no sé? ¿Cómo
the land is dying.
¿Hasta no sale este juego? What the fuck?
And the machines are out of control.
¿Cómo salió de allá? En 4 años después. Cinco, cuatro es demasiado optimista.
Whatever comes, I will be ready.
Son distintos, están perfectos. Dios, me tengo de colores, me perdí al mismo tiempo.
Wow, Game Awards Orchestra, thank you so much. I am so ready for this game. Thank you so much to Lauren and the orchestra, and in her first ever performance and trip to the United States, the beautiful Julie Elvin. Thank you so much, Julie. Well, speaking of music, last week you probably saw everyone posting their Spotify Wrapped on social media. My top artists of 2021, Rufus Du Sol, Sam Fender, and Dayglow. You can make your Spotify Wrapped now in the app and stick around as we reveal for the first time the most listened to Spotify artists and songs on gaming consoles in 2021. Also on the music front, some of the music we've been playing tonight is from Sessions Diana. Sessions is Riot Games' project with music made to be safe to stream without fears of copyright issues. Check out sessions.riotgames.com to download the full album. And now it's time for a special and long-awaited announcement.
Cloud, let us defy destiny together.
Gonna drop plate number 7.
You're gonna do what?
What the? This will be a memory to cherish for the rest of your lives.
What have you done?
They deserve what's coming to them.
Yeah, but I'm not your sister.
Now,
let the hunt begin.
Surrender to the darkness. Embrace it.
This is just wrong.
Hundreds of games to choose from. PC. Are you a player? Then do some. Download high quality PC games. Y'all better remember our name.
What's your name?
Game Pass. Xbox Game Pass for PC.
2021 Game Awards. Xbox Game Pass for PC. And you too. What do we think?
You know, it's so effortful.
I like that we animated.
You're welcome.
Okay, I understand the impulse to do something big. But what do PC gamers actually want? Because I don't think it's that.
They love brand new PC games.
We have some great ones coming day one.
Okay.
Some of them haven't even been announced yet.
Okay, great. Marketing idea. What if Gata tweets out this list, more or less leaking it in a cool, hip way? I retweet it because I have so many more followers than him.
It's done.
What's done?
Tweet it. It's out there.
No, you didn't. I don't think you should have.
Proactivity ain't a crime, man.
We'll figure it out.
When people think about Xbox Game Pass, they think about console. They don't know we're a PC gaming service.
Why not just call it PC Game Pass?
That's a great idea.
Really good.
Okay, we're going with that.
Just like that, you're gonna change the name of the whole thing because of Gata, who calls himself Gata.
It's a good name.
All we gotta do is add some top tier streamers to this to really land it.
Gata, yes. What about 100 Thieves?
Big fans.
Was that 100 Thieves?
Where are the other 97?
I get it, that's funny.
Thank you, man, we'll take it from here, brother. We got cameos, we got ideas percolating, right? Next steps to me are just talking about like how we bill you.
Wait, hold on. Are we really gonna make an ad for the Game Awards and you're not gonna rap in it at all?
I mean, if I could get away with that.
Game Pass has PC games.
Yeah, we do.
Yeah, we are at the TGAs.
I guess that's kind of like saying we're at the Game Awards.
Yeah, PC Game Pass.
Come on.
Hello, Game Awards. My name is Martin Foss Anderson, aka Mr. Savage. It's really bad if you're stressed before you're trying to play a game and trying to win it. If I was stressed after school, I just wouldn't be able to focus properly, and it would just make everything 10 times harder. Together with Truth, I have an important message. Vaping nicotine can increase anxiety symptoms and stress levels. I think it's really important people know the truth about vaping nicotine.
Guys, what's up?
Oh yeah. Oh yeah.
Sorry, I'm here to present the Game Award for Best Action, I guess.
And oh shoot, that's so sick.
Sorry. So you know, as a martial arts superhero myself, I know a little thing or two about action and oh snap, with the plasma sword? Sorry. Where was I? The prompter, right. Action is the best when it's kinetic and fast-paced and totally organic to the... No, you did not, Master Chief! Oh, you didn't!
Interesting.
Sorry, guys. Look, you guys know that Halo just came out, right? And it's literally sitting in my living room while I gotta be here. So instead of actually playing Halo, I'm on stage presenting the Game Award for Best Action while watching streamers on Twitch. Seemed like a pretty reasonable compromise. Anyway, here are the nominees.
Best Action Game.
Is not won by the fearless.
It's won by the feared.
Things have changed. Everything has changed.
Sorry. And the Game Award for Best Action Game goes to... Returnal.
Wow, thank you. We are so happy to be here to accept the award for everyone who worked on Returnal. When I first joined Housemarque, I could tell Returnal was a really special game, and it was our amazing team that pulled it off and brought you the game that you played today. Thank you to the amazing team at Housemarque in Helsinki, Finland, our incredible co-dev partners who helped us build Returnal, our amazing partners at XDev, represented by Pedro, and everyone at PlayStation. We're so grateful we could build a game like Returnal. But biggest thanks, obviously, has to go to the players. Thank you for playing, and thank you for supporting Returnal. Wonderful.
Thank you.
that be?
It is.
Just start at the beginning.
We landed on Mars. It looked wrong. Like we were in a dream.
And you boarded Savathun's ship. Wicked thing, Velour.
Yeah, we wanted to find her. Try to gain the upper hand. But she was baiting us.
What happened next?
My ghost brought me back. We kept going. She knew we would.
And that's when you saw the night.
I'll never forget it.
Absolutely sure it was light. Savathun's illusions can fool the senses.
No. I know what I saw. This is real.
What made you push forward?
We needed to know what that thing was. We couldn't stop.
What has she done?
Looks so good. Destiny of the Witch Queen, that is coming out in February. And everything you saw there is actually from the first mission of the game, which is so cool. And Bungie is celebrating their 30th anniversary this year, so congratulations to Bungie, and there's a lot of great stuff happening in Destiny 2 right now to celebrate 30 years of Bungie. All right, now it is time to get to another new game announcement. A few months ago, a Japanese game creator reached out to me and said, "Hey, I want to announce my next game at the Game Awards, and I'm so honored to have this opportunity to present this global announcement to all of you. Please enjoy."
Kojima? No creo que Kojima presente algo ahora. Oh, sí, es él. Bueno, ¿quién es? Silent Hill. Oh, espera. Este no es el... Joder, ¿cómo se llamaba esta mierda? Es Kojima. Sí, pero es Kojima, ¿no? No, ¿o no? No, este no es el otro, el Hassam... no sé qué. Hassam Haran o algo así. No, este es el otro. Studio.
That's a fun one. It's clear Toriyama san has not abandoned his roots. Thank you again for that very special announcement. Speaking of just that, we have another brand new game to announce from a studio comprised of many industry veterans. Check this out.
Yeah. diseño, Dios.
Ever since the day the portal network collapsed, stranding us in these realms, we have searched for a way home.
Dios, soy increíble.
Lost and alone in the dangerous labyrinth of fantastical worlds.
Dios, cuántas cosas.
Welcome to the lands of Fae.
Is a chance for salvation. Uniting the lost survivors. Or leading us deeper into this nightmare. Nightingale, our beacon of hope. But beyond our reach, as long as we stand together, our journey will unite us.
You, the Realmwalkers, are all that is left.
Love brand new IP, and joining me now is Aaron Flynn from Inflection Games. Aaron, you were on stage at the first Game Awards in 2014, accepting Game of the Year for Dragon Age, and now you've got a new studio, Inflection, up in Canada. What kind of game do we get here with Nightingale?
Oh, well, thanks, Jeff. Yeah, so it's a survival crafting game, shared world idea, so we want to bring players together, solo experiences, cooperative experiences, lots of ability to go and explore these amazing, fantastical, magical realms we're going to give players, lots of ability to come together, cooperate, lots of opportunity for community building, that sort of thing.
Wow, it looks incredible. I said, I love, show me this game a while ago. I was like, this looks so cool. We have to show this to people. And you're pretty far along. That's real gameplay footage, so people will play it next year?
Yeah, absolutely, yeah. So we're going to be in early access next year on PC only. And looking forward to inviting players in. If you want to see more, playnightingale.com.
Amazing. All right, well, thank you for that announcement. A nice surprise for the Game Awards. And tonight, we've got much more coming up, but we're also going to introduce you to our Game Awards second annual Future Class, a group of 50 individuals who represent the bright, bold, and inclusive future of our industry. You can see the full list at thegameawards.com tonight. We're also partnering with Google Play to have our Future Class mentor the next generation of women in gaming. Google Play's Change the Game aims to improve female representation in gaming. For the next 12 months, a selected group of teenagers will receive hands-on guidance from last year's Future Class as mentors. Right now, meet one of the new members of our Future Class.
Oh, hi. I'm DJ Knight, and I stream on Twitch.
Oh, they gotta hate me right now, and I love it. My focus is primarily joy. Everybody has the potential to be cynical about everything.
This game sucks. I hate it. I hate everything and ever.
It's easy to do that. It's much more enjoyable to find the good. A lot of that started when I was in the military. Finding out that people shot rockets at your plane, it's a reminder that nothing is promised. Do you want to look back on your life into negativity or focus on the good?
Hello world, I'm Miroslav Beck from Beat Games, and I'm thrilled to announce our new Music Pack collaboration. Lady Gaga Music Pack launches on Beat Saber tonight. See you all in multiplayer.
Asequible. Aparte, joder, el quest. Aunque perdieron la cuna.
Don't let them see us, precious. They'll find us. They'll see us.
Hi Game Awards, it's Ms. Tech. Final Fantasy XIV just released its latest expansion, Endwalker. And to celebrate, they're partnering with Grubhub on something really cool. Check out this piece I did with them and enjoy the rest of your show. All right, everyone, let's focus up. It's time to raid. All right, this is the top part. Get ready to stack. Yes, we got it.
Woo, pizza party.
Seriously, where did you get the pizza?
Now when you order with Grubhub using code ENDWALKER, you get free delivery and unlock an exclusive pizza emote in Final Fantasy XIV.
That's so beautiful. I'm crying on my pepperoni.
We've all been there.
I'm a setting sun, but I'll never run.
I'm a dead man walking. I'm a dead man walking.
And kill till I die. The crazy spree, I'm going mad. I can't rush just like that. The soldiers need a lot of bad. My future's in a body bag. I'm squawking on like a bite. The reaper's so close behind me. Its cold breath reminds me. The shadow that death must find me. I'm a dead man before I die. Before I die. I'll take every soul I can into the night. Oh. And kill till I die.
What's up, everybody? I am Ariel Powers. I'll be presenting the best mobile game presented by Verizon. Afterwards, come join us for the Game Awards Watch Party on Nate Hill's Twitch channel. I'll see you soon.
Back in the summer of 2019, I visited this first-time developer at his studio in the United Kingdom. He told me his dream was to one day share his game with the world at the Game Awards. Well, that dream is about to come true. Enjoy.
Si que me presento algo, va a ser hasta el final. Sí, sí es que presento algo. Dios, qué sensación de tamaño.
I cannot wait to play Somerville, thanks to Chris Olsen and the team at Jumpship for that one. Next, we're going to head to the stage for a very special performance from a much-loved game studio.
Enchanted land. What better way to explore the island than with a leisurely climb into the mountains? Just remember to watch your step. Or perhaps the icy tundra is more to your liking. Don't forget to pack your mittens. Look out for the walloping winter whale. Next stop, the dramatic Western Plains under the watchful eye of Sheriff Winchester. Yee-haw! But what's this? Why, it's Chef Saltbaker with his famous cookies. He's the best baker in the land. His cookies are sure to put some pep in your step. Oh! And you'll need it. For there's a new challenge waiting around every corner on the amazing DLC Island.
We have a date, June 30th, 2022. So exciting, the delicious last course. All right, next up, earlier you saw the trailer for Sonic 2, the movie, and now it's time for the little blue guy to give you a glimpse at his next game, also coming in 2022.
What's your game, the Sonic? Sonic. Sonic Brothers. 2022. Dios.
TGA の皆さん、こんにちは。小島秀夫です。今年もですね、TGA に参加できなくてごめんなさい。来年は必ず出席させていただきます。僕の戦友であります、ギレルモ・デルトロ監督の最新作、ナイトメアアレイをご紹介します。どうぞ。
I got a little job for you. It's just temporary.Folks here, they don't make no never mind who you are or what you've done. Everything's got to be new these days. Sensational.
Let the mirrors show you who you are.
What's your pitch, pal? You on the level?
I'd love to learn anything that you want to teach me.
I can read a mark quick, find out what they want.
Folks will pay good money just to make themselves feel better. When a man believes his own lies and people get hurt, then you lie. You try to find your way out.
I warned you, didn't I?
There is no way out.
Wow, that was the best trailer I've seen since Death Stranding. Now, on to awards business. I am honored to be announcing the Best Art Direction category. These nominees, across a broad variety of budgets and genres, each found their own path to combining visual design, music, and animation into their own distinct expression of intent and purpose. You know, one franchise I love the art direction in, Silent Hill. I hope we get a new one of those.Anyhow, here are the nominees for Best Art Direction.
Best Art Direction.
And the Game Award for Best Art Direction goes to Deathloop.
This is super weird.Because last night I made the bet that Guillermo del Toro will be giving this award, so this is awkward. I will stick to my speech. So thank you, Guillermo, wherever you are. Thanks to the Game Awards. I now have a flashback of when I was studying the 60s era by watching his movie, The Shape of Water, scrutinizing the sets, the colors, the lighting. So thanks for your indirect participation, Guillermo.Also, thank you for rewarding our risk talking, our passion for visual expression, our level of craftsmanship, and our attention to details that our players seem to really appreciate, isn't it? Tonight, I'm proud, ladies and gentlemen, and I think the guys across the ocean at Arkane are really proud too. Thanks to them for this fucking cool adventure. Thanks to my longtime art buddies, Damien and Jean-Luc. Dinga Bakaba, well, thanks you, bro. We did it.Thanks to the great people at Bethesda, Sony, and Microsoft. A big hug for our families and friends. And lastly, I'd like to dedicate this award to the boss, Robert Altman. Peace, amour, and French fries. Yes, I lost a bet last night also.
Congratulations to all the winners so far, and right now we are excited to announce additional winners tonight. In the 100% fan-voted Player's Voice category, here are the final five nominees, as voted on by fans. And the Game Award goes to Halo Infinite. Congratulations. For Best RPG, the nominees are And the game award goes to Tales of Arise. For best score and music, those nominees are... And the game award goes to Near Replicant. Next up is Content Creator of the Year. But first, let's hear from fans and creators themselves on who they want to win.
For Creator of the Year, I want Dream to win. Good luck, Dream.
It's all about the beard, people. You gotta vote for Evi.
Hi, my name is Emily. I would like to nominate Foosley for Creator of the Year.
Well, let's see who was right. Here are the nominees for Content Creator of the Year. And the Game Award goes to Dream. Congratulations, Dream. Of course, not here in person. Here are the nominees for Best Multiplayer Game. And the Game Award goes to It Takes Two. Joseph, you did it. I learned to keep microphones away from him. Congrats. Now to present the best mobile game, please welcome WNBA player and Team Liquid streamer, Ariel Powers.
Thanks, Jeff. Here are the nominees for Best Mobile Game presented by Verizon. And the game award goes to Genshin Impact. Stay right here. We've got more game awards coming up after this.
What's good, Chicago? What the deal be? This is Khalif Adams here in full effect, rocking with y'all of the Spawn Me Podcast, the premier podcast spotlighting people of color in the video game industry.
I think when you have those really seminal moments within culture and within the world where you see something that throws you, you know, you just don't know what to do. You feel confused, you feel upset, you feel hurt. But the thing that I can do and put out into the world is a show.
I know that things right now are very, very difficult. I know that things are all over the place in lots of different ways.
It's scary, man. I mean, there's no other way to put it. It is scary to be black in this country today.
I'm a black mom, so I'm scared.
A lot of people in gaming communities just don't want to hear it.
We sat down for about 2 hours or so, just kind of ran through our feelings and emotions.
Because it's all, I don't want to bring politics. Well, I'm f***ing glad that you can ignore this shit because it's quote unquote politics when this is a lot of people's reality.
So the show goes up, it launches. So I would see all these tweets. Hey, you need to listen to this. Hey, you need to check this out. Hey, you need to be paying attention to this. And then one of the big outlets caught it. Then it just moved.
Let's just speak the 100% truth. It is not.
You know, I'd always wanted to use my voice in a way that felt powerful, really bring home the conversation about doing a show through a prism of blackness. I think we did the job in a really good way. And I think the world and the industry was better for it.
No sé, puestos a hablar de racismo, hay que hablar de todo. Creo yo. Creo que sobre yo. Pero sí, mierda, debes haber dicho eso.
I can play all my favorite games straight from the cloud.
That's right. I can play on my Fire TV, tablet, and phone. Yo, Brandon, what's that game you keep talking about?
Which one? The lineup looks awesome. Yakuza Like a Dragon, Devil May Cry 5, yeah. Judgment, Rainbow Six Extraction. I can play any game without waiting for long downloads.
There are so many great games. Luna Couch, anyone?
I'm in. Feels like I'm on your couch.
Let's go.
on trending?
Yeah.
Hi.
Blessed Sigma, the world drowns in corruption. Your empire is aflame with heresy. The faithful perish, and the wicked multiply. Blessed Sigma, lend me your strength. Grant me the will to purge the corrupt, to smite the heretic, to bring hope when hope is lost. By the comet and the hammer, I pledge to the coming battle. I vow not to waver and never retreat. To stand tall against the flames of perdition. To drive back the shadow of chaos with your holy light. Finished praying, have you? Where is your patience, Master Dwarf? Have I ever let you down? Victory favors the faithful. Let us teach them fear. For Sigma and the Empire!
She's an actor who stars in The Mandalorian and the upcoming series The Book of Boba Fett. Please welcome Ming-Na Wen.
A gaming narrative is more than a collection of cutscenes. It represents our own involvement with the story and its characters. To be nominated for the Best Narrative Award, a great game demands provocative dialogue and a captivating plot. But above all, it must exhibit a meaningful involvement with the audience. And also, just speaking as the mother of a son who loves gaming, it's nice when there's more to the story than just blowing up grenade factories and shouting obscenities at your alligator brides. Here are the nominees for Best Narrative.
Best Narrative.
Every loop I'm learning a little more, piecing together the puzzle.
It was a spell, I am telling you.
Ah! If it is a spell, how do we break it?
I need to find out exactly what happened that night.
I can reveal their secrets.
You have proven yourselves unworthy, and you must be destroyed!
My name is Raz, and today is my first day on the job.
And the Game Award for Best Narrative goes to... Marvel's Guardians of the Galaxy!
A surprise. There are so many people responsible for making this such a wonderful thing. I want to thank Marvel Game Studios for trusting us with their characters and for allowing us to make them our own, for our fabulous cast, for bringing them to life in ways that words on a page can never do, for Olivier, our producer, Hubert, JF, my game director, the entire crew who worked on it, and of course, my wonderfully wild, wacky, immensely talented writers. Thank you for making comedy look easy. Thank you for not complaining too often when I pushed you to remember our main themes of grief and to go deeper. Who am I kidding? I know you complained, but thank you for not doing it to me. Thank you, everyone. This is an honor.
¿Listo, tío?
Genia, 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 ea.
¿Cómo es esto? ¿Es que se puede transformar en animales?
What a beautiful game. All right, now we have something very special. The gameplay world premiere trailer for Rocksteady's newest title, Suicide Squad Kill the Justice League. We've all been waiting anxiously for them to give us a first look at...
Kaylee! What the hell do you think you're doing? That footage is strictly classified. My name is director Amanda Waller. And since the Game Awards doesn't care about disclosing classified intel, listen up. Whatever you've heard about Task Force X, the state of the Justice League, or Superman rampaging through the streets of Metropolis, you better not say a word ever to anyone.
Yes, ma'am.
Because if you do, believe you me, I'll hear about it. You've all been warned. Waller out.
She gone? She's gone. Good. All right. Well, I think we've waited long enough to see Rocksteady's new game. This is going to be worth the risk. You guys want to do it? Let's all watch this together.
When I think of the Justice League, I think of Wonder Woman, Superman, Green Lantern. You don't want to mess with that lot. But you, Barry, you're just the team mascot, aren't you, mate? The loser of the league, folks! The fastest man alive! It's the Flash!
Flash is alive, and he's playing for Team Brainiac.
I gave you orders. Kill the Flash, or I'll kill you myself.
Cool, cool.
Nothing can stop me!
Punching him!
On a screen, demon!
Did you get him? Really? Why don't you just mail me the bullet?
I'm the eye in the sky, taking point, Beam Shark!
Sasha Harris, that guy.
From the upcoming game Forspoken, here are the performers Ella Balinska and Pollyanna McIntosh.
Hi, I'm so excited to be here, Morgan.
You may have met the character I portray in Forspoken, Frey Holland. I am so excited to be here to announce a brand new trailer, and especially delighted tonight as we will be seeing Pollyanna's first portrayal of Tanta Prav for the very first time.
She is a ruthless adversary for Frey, and I hope players get into it, looking for a boss fight with this woman at some point.
I definitely hope that you're in a boss fight.
Thank you, Ella. That's so kind, even if it is with Frey.
Especially if it's with Frey. And now, a world premiere trailer for Forspoken.
Child. My name is Frey Holland. I do not know how I got here, and all I want is to go home.
She is hell's sport. How else did she survive in the corruption?
The people are afraid. They look to me in the council for hope that we cannot give them. But maybe you can. Wherever I go turns to shit. It's always been this way.
Athia is all but lost.
Everything that corruption touches,
it breaks. Yeah. I saw it up close.
It is you who trespass on my land. You who set this battle in motion.
How do you plead?
Not guilty.
Lies! She dies!
We've lost the square! We can't hold it!
Thank you.
Joining me now is Tim Willits from Saber and the star of the game who will play Captain Titus, Clive Standen. Tim, what did we just see?
Well, I'm just so excited I can finally talk about this game. Yeah. You know, we are making Space Marine 2, a sequel to the iconic, you know, Warhammer 40K game. You know, and at Saber, you know, we're using the experience that we have learned from games like Halo, Quake Champions, World War Z, to really bring this game to life, to make it the most intense action game ever. And we've got Clive as a Space Marine. It's awesome.
Clive, how does it feel to be in the game?
Oh, it's a dream, a pretty bleak and grim dream, but anyone who's ever seen any of the work I've done, I'm not scared of the darkness. I'm stoked and grateful to be a part of this. I used to play with and paint the Space Marines when I was a kid with my older brother, so the chance to play one of the most iconic characters in the Warhammer 40K universe is everything to me. So
it fits you. Looks good. So yeah. We're excited to see more of the game and awesome for you guys to show the gameplay. Tim, Clive, thank you so much for joining us. And right now, here's a brand new look at Saints Row.
People that can shoot guns?
Fuck you!
Que no hay más 23, ¿verdad? Parece que equilibran muy bien entre la comida y la serie, como así los.
There's still plenty of show left, and why would you want to watch alone when you could watch with me and Ariel Powers?
Exactly.
Tune into our watch party to see a lot of exclusive interviews and industrial strength takes.
Trust me, you do not want to miss it.
But don't take our word for it. Come to twitch.tv/NateHill, powered by Verizon 5G, and come check it out.
See you soon.
Your gear it up for all our war. Tornadoes are
MX are here.
Hey guys, FaZe Rug here, and I'm asking you to help me destroy 1 billion mechs for Able Gamers charity in the hit new game, Mech Arena. Join me and millions of players in 5-on-5 mech action for a chance to win insane prizes, raise money for a good cause, and get a shot at driving this real mech. Are you ready to battle? I'll see you in the arena.
Mech Arena.
What's one award? Is one award enough? Well, the gold medal. Was that enough? Nah.
Scar takes it!
Is one title enough? Nope. What about one sponsor? No way. With every win, you only want more. Because enough is never enough.
Welcome back. To present our next award, it's the man you just saw in that WD Black piece, and tonight you can get 10% off selected WD Black products to celebrate the Game Awards. Please welcome seven-time NBA All-Star and owner of Endemic, Paul George.
Good evening, everyone. I love action-adventure games for their versatility. One minute, you're solving a puzzle. The next, you're lining up headshots. And then suddenly, you're being put on a hook by a vampire lady taller than me. This category is like a showcase of what it means to be a video game. Here are the nominees for Best Action-Adventure Game.
Best Action-Adventure Game.
Guys, huddle up!
Just in time for the miracle. This shouldn't take too long. I've got eyes on the target.
Ratchet, the Dimensionator.
We thank you for waiting. And now let the games begin.
And the Game Award for Best Action-Adventure Game goes to Metroid Dread.
On behalf of the teams at Nintendo and Mercury Steam who worked on Metroid Dread, thank you so much for this award, and congratulations to all the other nominees. This is the action-adventure category, and Metroid Dread checks off both the action and the adventure box. It's filled with action-packed moments behind every door, around every corner, and on every level. And at the same time, it introduces us to a massive and mysterious new planet that players can explore and adventure through. It's the result of a true collaboration between Nintendo and Mercury Steam, and I have a few comments that the developers asked me to read on their behalf. We'd like to say a big thank you for this award from the development teams at Nintendo and Mercury Steam that worked so hard to bring all the Metroid fans around the world the experience that they were hoping for. It's been a dream come true to travel together in this dangerous yet marvelous journey to ZDR. We're so thankful for all the fans for enjoying Metroid Dread on Nintendo Switch. Thank you very much.
There it is, the biggest death trap in all history. And the Duke's headed into its jaws.
On Caladan, we ruled with air and sea power. Here, we must scrabble for desert power.
Move slowly.
And the day of your revenge will come.
This is your inheritance.
Speed is a device of Shaitan.
Thus, there will always be a desert on Arrakis.
What is to become of the
Baron Vladimir Harkonnen Doom?
If anything happens to me,
and tries to trouble
your enemy was overwhelming.
You'll not be irrelevant.
Yet you ruled with him.
We Fremen have a saying. God created Arrakis to train the faithful.
Arrakis!
To hold Arrakis, you're faced with
Arrakis. Is our enemy.
This is my honor.
This is my vengeance. This is my doom.
Please welcome two of the stars of the upcoming Tiny Tina's Wonderlands, Ashley Burch and Will Arnett. Oh, what's up, baby girls? Thank you for having us. We are so excited to reveal a bit about the story in Tiny Tina's Wonderlands.
Yeah. And are we talking about the Dragon Lord yet?
Yes, Will plays the Dragon Lord, the central villain within the Wonderlands.
Yes, but in a clever twist, I turn out to be the underdog hero of the entire realm, and it's really beautiful. And it's actually one of the main reasons that I took this role, so.
No.
What do you mean, no?
You play a necromantic overlord, and not the good kind.
Well, he's a job creator for millions of unemployed individuals.
He raises the dead, man.
Yeah, and he gives them stuff to do, okay? Some of them get to sail. Some form a rock band. A lot of them, like, I don't know, stab things or something.
Do you really not know the story of the game that you're in?
Sure, no. You mean the whimsical adventure from the mind of a 13-year-old demolitions expert? Yeah, who whimsically tries to blow up the heroes for 40 levels? Yeah, so if anyone is the central villain here, it's Tiny Tina.
All right, roll the damn trailer.
There is a world beyond the borderlands. A world forged by wonder and ruled by fate. There's one alone who can wield fate. One alone whose story is in their own hands. The Fate Maker. That's you. Heavy, right?
You seek passage. I can aid you.
I am Valentine, gallant adventurer. The scary stabby one is Fret.
The undead fall beneath our blades! Ah!
I'm sensing some real evil vibes this way. Now follow me!
A beautiful body indeed. And full of power!
I'm invincible!
Looking bad. How do we win this?
We attack! Together! For the queen!
You'll never get the Sword of Souls, you idiot!
You want a fight? I'll give you a fight!
That's a big boy! That's a big, big boy!
Sisters, I believe we have found our champion.
Oh, listen to me, lip-flapping, while you could be off adventuring.
Tina, you left a cheese curl on the board.
Mayhaps. It is a powerful ancient meteor, and it begins to rise from the ground.
This isn't a blessing. It's a blasting!
Hold on. What game are we playing here?
We're playing Bonkers and Badasses, baby!
We need more calcium out here!
Thank you.
last year one indie game won multiple game awards, and now they're back in a totally new, unexpected way. Pretty fun. All right, tonight we have a very special K-pop performance. The South Korean developer Pearl Abyss wanted to thank you for the great response to their recent trailer for their upcoming open-world action-adventure game, Dokkaebi. So they created a music video working with the popular K-pop dance team, 1 Million Dance Studio. Enjoy. We are wrapping up 2021 with Spotify, and here for the first time are the top three male and female artists as listened to by you on gaming consoles in 2021. Top female artists, Doja Cat, Billie Eilish, and Ariana Grande. Top male, Juice WRLD, XXXTentacion, and Polo G. Later we will reveal the most listened to Spotify songs. Now, a winner earlier tonight for Best Mobile Game, here's a look at two new characters coming December 14th to Genshin Impact, and the first glimpse of the upcoming character, Yeon Jin.
The sky is clear and the sun is shining. Time to get the Oni Kabuto out for some training. I'm the one who's supposed to be adored by the kids. Me!
Not if I have anything to say about it. To survive hardship, you must prepare for hardship.
Keep your weapon at the ready. You never know what's around the corner.
Numero uno EV.
Nintendo here in the flesh.
The king has gone insane.
He is a proponent of a theory called animal magnetism.
He's capable of anything.
This automatism must be. It could do much more than dance.
Angel of death, descended from the heavens to vanquish the clockwork tyrant. You're just as they describe. These machines feed on the dead. The greater the massacre, the deeper the river where they slake their thirst.
What's up, everyone? This is Matt Hafey, lead guitar player and lead singer of the metal band Trivium. I'm also a streamer on Twitch. I'm stoked to announce that I'm in Metal Hellsinger, a rhythm-based shooter game. Make sure you check it out. We also have incredible metal screamers, singers like myself, like Alyssa from Arch Enemy, Randy from Lamb of God. Check it out, my friends. I will see you all in hell.
Metal Hellsinger.
There was a soul. Had music inside. They called her the unknown.
Rushing.
Starting in 2022, there's a new way to play your favorite mobile games on your PC through Google Play Games. Take games from your pocket to your desktop and seamlessly pick up where you left off. Google Play Games on PC is coming soon in 2022. Next, here's another brand new game announcement for the first time at the Game Awards.
I
I enlisted because I didn't want to wait years just to get out and see the galaxy. I wanted to go somewhere, see new worlds, look up at a sky no one's ever seen before.
It's been a dream of mine since before I can remember. So I would be honored to become a captain someday. We need to learn everything we can.
You're not gonna die. Not if I have anything to say about it.
This can't be right.
Time to impact. 1 minute. Jara, I need you to do the right thing.
The fate of the negotiations, the interests of the Federation, and the prospect for peace may very well depend on it.
He's back again. Make some noise for Reggie.
Thank you. Wow. You know, Jeff said it earlier. Isn't it great to be back live and in person, back amongst friends? It's fantastic. This is a wonderful time of the year. The Game Awards. Our opportunity to celebrate the creators and the players. What is this, Jeff? Eighth year? Something like that? So much, you know, we've witnessed so much over these past few years, the launch of next generation 8 and 9 consoles, the mobile revolution, streaming games, VR, AR, and quality free-to-play games. And this category represents another innovation in our industry. This is the award for best ongoing game. It used to be that a game would ship, and that would be the game. But today's developers keep players coming back to their beloved titles again and again by delivering and creating exciting new content. Here are the 5 nominees who are engaging their audiences year after year.
Best ongoing game.
And the Game Award for the best ongoing game goes to Final Fantasy.
Tonight, Final Fantasy XIV Online also wins Best Community Support.
This is quite the honor to win Best Ongoing Game. The category had so many amazing nominees that it's truly fortunate that we were able to win. There's an incredible team behind Final Fantasy XIV who pour their hearts into the work, bringing new and memorable stories and adventures to our fans, from A Realm Reborn all the way to Endwalker and beyond. So a big thank you to Final Fantasy XIV team, and can't wait to see what's going on in the future. And honestly, the biggest thanks to our community. They've been our rock, and we're so happy that you continue to give us our support. Thank you so much.
Since the dawn of time, we have sought the glory of competition. But it wasn't always what you'd call friendly. As civilization evolved, so did the desire for battle and the drive to be the best. Cities grew, and soon everyone wanted a piece of the action. Some for power, some fame, but many just love the thrill of the fight. Even today. Oh, come on!
That was Rumbleverse, coming next year from Iron Galaxy and Epic Games. And tomorrow, there's a first look gameplay event. Head to rumbleverse.com to sign up. Now, here's the world gameplay debut of a sequel to a Game Awards nominee from a few years ago, A Plague Tale: Requiem.
Under the wide and starry sky. Dig the grave and let me lie.
Amicia, come!
Hugo, I'm right behind you!
Glad did I live and gladly die. And I laid me down with a will.
Impossible.
This be the verse you grave for me.
Come on, you've seen worse than this.
Here he lies, where he longed to be. Home is the sailor, home from sea, and the hunter, home from the hill.
I don't know what's happening to me, Lucas. I feel my mind going.
I know. Think of your brother. We have to carry on.
Oh, no. What have you done?
This year, we partnered with Grubhub to do something really cool to get your food delivered for the Game Awards. Order Grubhub using the code ENDWALKER during the show to get free delivery on all orders of $15 or more and an exclusive Final Fantasy 14 Eat Pizza emote for the game. I know you get some dinner. We got lots of shows still to go. This year, Techland celebrated its 30th anniversary, and next year, Dying Light 2 arrives after a long wait. We've got a new look right now at the game's story with this CG trailer.
Hurry up!
Oh my God!
Oh my God! island you once knew has flipped. Welcome to Chapter 3, where there are brand new places to explore and exciting new ways to experience Fortnite like never before. Start by earning Battle Pass XP beyond Battle Royale. It's all about playing your way to level up and unlock Battle Pass outfits, including Spider-Man. There's also new features to check out. Get around more quickly and evade enemy fire with new sliding and swinging. And even set up camps where you and your squad can heal and store items from match to match. Plus, there are new weapons and items to help win a victory royale.
And a victory royale.
And earn the ultimate prestige, the victory crown. The Daily Bugle, along with many more locations. And with the island's new weather conditions, anything can happen. In addition to all new gameplay, check out the Chapter 3 Season 1 Battle Pass that features Spider-Man, The Foundation, and more newcomers. So what are you waiting for? Drop into Chapter 3 and start exploring the new island, because you'll never know what you might find.
It's been a great year so far for Shark Mob on their first game, Blood Hunt. They just completed a successful early access, and I'm very excited for their full release next year. Blood Hunt will be out on PS5 and PC in spring 2022 and will be free to play. Back when I started the Game Awards in 2014, this band made a bet on me and the show, and few believe we could make the Game Awards a reality. 7 years later, Imagine Dragons is back at the Game Awards for a once-in-a-lifetime performance that celebrates 10 years of Supergiant Games and their first release, Bastion. Please welcome Imagine Dragons, featuring the composers and songwriters behind all of Supergiant's games, Darren Korb and Ashley Barrett.
I dig my hope you build a wall. I dig my hope you build a wall.
Those tears are gonna spill.
So build that wall and build it strong, 'cause we'll be there before too long. Gonna build that wall until it's done.
eso no lo...
I wake up to the sound of the silence that allows my mind to run around with my ear up to the ground, searching to behold the stories that I told. My back was to the world that was smiling when I turned. Tell you you're the greatest, but once you turn the haters, hey! Oh, the misery, everybody wants to be my enemy. Spare the sympathy, everybody wants to be my enemy. On the wall, is he praying for my fall? Laughter in the hall, the names that I've been called. I stack it in my mind, and I'm waiting for the time to show you what it's like to be worse made in mind. Tell you you're the greatest, but once you turn the haters, ha! Oh, the misery, everybody wants to be my enemy.
Pray for me. I'm praying that somebody hope for me. I'm staying where nobody supposed to be. Posted, being a wreck of emotion. Ready to go whenever you let me know. The road is long, so put the pedal to the flow. The enemy on my trail, my enemy is available. I'ma tell
hasta luego.
They wanna plow on my trot to the top. I've been out of shape, thinking out of the box. I'm an astronaut. I blasted off the planet, rocking to cause catastrophe, and it matters more because I had it. Had I thought about wreaking havoc on an opposition, kind of shocking. They want a static with precision. I'm automatic. Quarterback, I ain't talking second. Pack it, pack it up. I don't panic. Better, better. Up, who the baddest? It don't matter because we just.
God, that is so great. Thank you to Imagine Dragons, JID, and Ashley Barrett and Darren Korb. That's something you will only see at the Game Awards. Tonight, we partnered with Chevrolet to make the Game Awards live stream more accessible, including an audio descriptive stream, ASL stream with Deaf Gamers TV on Twitch, and closed captions. It's important. And now, to present the Innovation and Accessibility Award, please welcome Jacksepticeye and a member of our future class from 2020 and one of the judges who helped select the nominees for accessibility, the incredible Morgan Baker.
Thank you, Jeff. It's an honor to be here tonight. Games are for everyone. And this award recognizes the teams that are advancing gameplay, features, and technology to make sure games can be accessed and played by all.
It's incredible to see the effort developers put into prioritizing people who often go ignored, sharing their work with as many people as possible. And that's why we love being able to show our gratitude to those who go above and beyond each year, discovering new and creative methods to encourage inclusion. Here are the nominees.
Innovation and Accessibility, presented by Chevrolet.
In an update that will be coming shortly after launch, players will be able to enable a sign language interpreter.
Escort the blind girl 500 miles down a treacherous valley in the wake of an invading horde.
esta cosa de accesibilidades.
And the Game Award for Innovation in Accessibility goes to Forza Horizon 5.
Tonight, Forza Horizon 5 also wins Best Sports / Racing Game.
Thank you. This award means so much to our team because everyone at Playground Games is really committed to accessibility, so much so that we made it one of our core pillars for Forza Horizon. Around the world, there are about 1 billion players who have some sort of disability that makes gaming a challenge for them. And I think it's great that us as developers and as creators can add in accessibility features and options and just open the magic of video games to more and more players. I'd like to thank a few people. I'd like to thank Alan Hartman, Matt Booty, Tara Volker, Ben Williams, and all of Team Xbox, as well as our accessibility champs, Tanya, Aaron, and Ryan. And with that, I'll go because it's telling me to wrap it up. When everyone plays, we all win.
What a great sentiment, such an important word. Congratulations, guys. All right, well, joining me now is Simon Vicklin from 10 Chambers. Simon, back in 2017, we announced your studio and your first game at GTFO right here at the Game Awards, and we're thrilled to have you back. I understand tonight you've got a special announcement for everyone?
Yes. It was a great opportunity to show off the game. Was it 4 years ago?
Yeah.
And
something's about to happen tonight, I think.
Yes,
right?
yes, indeed. The thing is, it helped us reach, you know, the audience for our extreme co-op horror game.
Yes.
And we thought, what better way to announce 1.0?
Yeah.
We've been in early access now for 2 years. What better way to announce 1.0 than to come back to the Game Awards? So the surprise announcement is that GTFO is out now. This very minute, we release it right now.
Someone pressed a button.
Exactly. Back home in Sweden, someone's pressing a button right now.
Amazing.
And it's out now. And there's no better time to get into GTFO than right now, with 25% off. And you know, we worked hard to make the game more accessible.
Yeah.
Sorry, more accessible. And yeah.
Well, let's take a look. We've
let's
got
take a look
brand
at the trailer.
New.
Yeah.
All right, 1.0 GTFO. Thanks so much, Simon. Check it out.
They wake us from our nightmares to make us new ones. A descent into a vast underground complex where every resource scavenged might give you one more chance. There's only one rule.
Let us just get in and get out.
Bring it what it wants. Or die. In the dark.
No sudden moves.
Where the monsters wait.
They're all over us!
Why are we here? What terrible things do we do to deserve such hell? All we know is we'll have to work together, or we'll die together.
Thank you.
juego GTA. Eso. Con razón no entendí GTA. Hecho en Unity.
My name is Mike. I go by Mike the Quad, and I stream on Twitch.
Let's go!
I joined the military in 2008. When we came back, I was involved in a motorcycle accident. Trying to figure out how to use a controller without having any hand function.
Yo, what's up, everybody?
That kind of sparked my advocacy. I wholeheartedly believe it kickstarts a patient's rehabilitation.
Raid Shadow Legends, I mean, wow. You pick your champions, they're glorious, and their shields, oh, they glisten like wet otters. But the bad guys, they're Lovecraftian, they're spooky, they're big. And then you go to battle, and it's like, then finally your foe is vanquished, and that satisfaction is such a primal feeling, ooh.
Download Raid Shadow Legends. Get exclusive free bonus pack with TGA 2021 promo code.
I need to do terrible things again. Now we must find the prophet and kill him.
Will we finally hunt the circle?
Yes. I'm done running. To strike.
Play it now with Game Pass.
Halo Infinite launched yesterday, and I know I'm playing it this weekend, and I am excited to watch next year when Steven Spielberg's Emblem Television, Showtime, and 343 Industries bring the legendary Master Chief to life in the live-action Halo original series streaming exclusively on Paramount+. Here is the world premiere first look trailer.
You're special. In fact, I'm counting on it.
We're lost in the dark. But you give people hope. And I will always be with you. I see this as a new beginning.
Chief Creative Officer from Epic Games, Donald Mustard.
That was crazy. That was amazing. All right. So making games that are original, innovative, and really push the medium forward is not easy at all. It's the culmination of the work and the talent of hundreds and hundreds of people and countless hours. And it only happens when there's a clear, shared vision of what a game can be. These nominees for Best Game Direction represent what's possible when it all comes together.
Best Game Direction. You have no idea what's out there.
Sure I do. Freedom.
Are you ready for the roller coaster ride of your life?
Red Cody Ride!
Is anyone listening? It's Celine.
My name is Raz, and I'm the new intern.
This is the part where you lose.
Oh, so awesome. All right, and the award for Best Game Direction goes to Deathloop.
So Deathloop is my first game as a game director, and it's also the first game that Sebastian and I are co-creative director for. And actually, I don't mean that as a brag. It was terrifying, terrifying for us, terrifying for the team. I really want to thank the Arcane Lyon team for, you know, taking the leap of faith of giving their best work to make this strange game that no one can sum up in 30 seconds, actually work. And and also thank you to PlayStation. You believed in our vision. Thank you to our fans. And actually, I have a lot of people to thank, but not a lot of time. Can we make those 30 seconds loop? A couple of times?
For Fortnite.
Okay. Okay, well, I'll stop here, but just if you allow me a small last word for my family in French. So, Lilia, Aya, Papa, Maman, je vous aime très fort. Merci. Thank you very much.
Now it's time to take a look at some other award winners tonight. In the category of Best Esports Game, presented by Grubhub, here are the nominees. And the Game Award goes to League of Legends. Congratulations. For Family Game, here are the nominees. And the Game Award goes to It Takes Two. Here are the nominees for Best Fighting Game. And the Game Award goes to Guilty Gear Strive. Next, Best Sim Strategy Game. Here are the nominees. And the Game Award goes to Age of Empires 4. Next, the nominees for Best VR AR Game. And the Game Award goes to Resident Evil 4 VR. And finally, your most anticipated game presented by Prime Gaming. Here are the nominees. And the Game Award goes to Elden Ring for the second year in a row. All right, well, everyone, our next guest is a little shy. If anyone in the audience has any twin blades or wing spears, I'm talking to you, Reggie, I'm going to ask that you please put those away for now. Let's bring him out here. He's a little shy, but look, everybody, it's my pot friend. Come on out, pot friend. Great to see you. You should put a bow tie on or something. Come on out, pot friend. Don't be shy. Looks like he's got a note or something. You got a note there, pot friend? Yeah, all right. Let's see. Let's see what this note says. Thanks, pot friend. Good evening. Please enjoy my gift. A new trailer for Elden Ring. I guess we've got another world premiere trailer. Thanks, buddy. Let's check it out. Yes.
Este juego. Lo quiero.
It happened an age ago.
Giorgio.
But when I recall, I see it true. On a night of wintry fog, the rune of death was stolen. And the demigods began to fall. Starting with Godwin the Golden. Queen Mariko was driven to the brink.
Fuck.
The shattering ensued, a war that wrought only darkness. The Elden Ring was broken. But by whom? And why?
Las referencias a Berserk. Rise.
What could the demigods ever hope to win by warring? These two were the mightiest to remain, and locked horns in combat. But there would be no victor. Awaiting the arrival of the Elden Lord. Unless, of course, thou shouldst take the crown.
Dios, esto es demasiado bueno. February 25.
Good. Just confirming the date, the same. February. Okay. Excellent. Good to see. Amazing. I can't wait to step deeper into the world of Elden Ring when it does come out in February. Tonight, we've teamed up with Spotify to reveal what you're listening to every day on gaming consoles as part of Spotify's Wrapped. So what were the most listened to songs in 2021 on gaming surfaces? Here are the top three. Rapstar by Polo G, Montero by Lil Nas X, and Mood by 24K Golden featuring Ian Dior. Congratulations, and make sure to make your Spotify Wrapped tonight. Stick around, because coming up, Keanu Reeves and Carrie Ann Moss reveal The Matrix Awakens. We debut a brand new next generation game, and the Game Awards Orchestra pays tribute to our Game of the Year nominees.
Well, well, well.
Well, go ahead and break off, old-timer.
You don't think I know rule one? You break off.
I never break a rule two.
Rule two? Oh, you're one of them. I've got all day, baby.
Break off? You know you want to.
Never. Well, respect. Respect.
But seriously, break off.
I fell into games, and I lived and breathed them for so long. I just never knew that it could be a job that I could be good at. I'm Anissa Sanusi.
Now it's a boss fight. Hi.
And I'm a UI UX designer in video games.
Hi.
Hi, how are you doing?
Oh my God, it's actually been...
I was born and raised in Malaysia, but I came to the UK at age 19. If you're a minority working in video games, you kind of go through life feeling like you're an imposter. I think that's what made me wish I had somebody to talk to. So I decided to create my own mentorship program. Limit Break is aimed at underrepresented people working in the UK game industry.
Hi.
I was wondering if you can help me out.
Let's take stock.
I feel like people just really want to be connected and be a part of a community. I feel like anybody who wants to make video games should be able to make video games.
What's up, everyone? I'm Sydney Goodman, and I'm about to step into the Fear Truck to play some Resident Evil 4. I am terrified, but excited.
Oh,
oh,
shit.
Oh,
shit.
Right off your feet.
Hey everyone, my name is Jonathan Thibault. My go-to is probably gonna be It Takes Two.
Hi everybody, my pick is Psychonauts 2.
Gonna have to give it to Ratchet and Clank Rift Apart. A pure joyride of fun from start to finish, and that's hard to beat.
That was a look at which Game of the Year nominees YouTube creators and fans want to see win later tonight. We'll find out if they are right when we present Game of the Year. Every year at the Game Awards, we try to find games that push the medium forward in new and unexpected ways. This game comes from Embark Studios in Sweden, a new team of veteran developers. Their first game brings together thrilling multiplayer PvE action, a next-generation physical sandbox, and incredible visuals to create a truly dynamic player experience. Here's the reveal, complete with real gameplay.
There is no way to hide. Kings, barons, queens. We give them different names, but they're all the same. Killing machines falling from the sky. This is our home. Our bastion of resistance. This is where the brave meets the bold. We will not die in the shadows. We will face our fears head on.
The giant just left orbit. Coming in down hot.
Showtime.
Somebody said Superman's coming in hot.
Out ahead.
Right there. Shit! Too many of them. Hold back. Now.
Look out.
Confirmed impact. Baron is on the
ground. You owe me one.
Perfect.
Let's do this.
Come on.
They will never stop coming.
Marks on screen, calling for volunteers. Enlist. Resist.
That was incredible. And now we have two special guests joining us for a very special moment. Carrie Ann, Keanu, welcome. I'm sure you guys recognize this iconic scene moment, right?
Jeff, thank you. It's good to be here at the Game Awards. And yes, this is one of the scenes that made The Matrix feel so groundbreaking and perhaps inspired a few video games, too.
Impressive.
Thanks.
Can you still do that?
Absolutely not. But I can in the Unreal Engine 5. I believe everyone here is expecting to see something new. So here's a never-before-seen look at The Matrix Resurrections, exclusively for the Game Awards. 2021! Let's roll the clip.
Tokyo. A moving portal makes it harder to track us. Seek is the best of them.
Portal's clean. Reading no shadows.
I don't remember this.
We don't have to run to phone booths anymore either.
always on your right.
Set and setting, right?
Oh, no.
It's all about set and setting.
After our first contact went so badly, we thought elements from your past might help ease you into the present.
Nothing comforts anxiety like a little nostalgia.
The Matrix Resurrections looks awesome, and we can't wait to watch it on December 22nd. But getting back to tonight's theme, which is the world of interactive entertainment, I have to say, Keanu, you've been in several great video games and immersive experiences. Did you ever think that one day a game could look as real as being in the Matrix?
Absolutely. I mean, we are reaching the point at which the line between the physical and virtual worlds are blurry.
And with interactive storytelling reaching stunning levels of fidelity, maybe it's fair to ask, what is a game? What is a movie?
Over 20 years ago, The Matrix pushed the boundaries of filmmaking and visual effects. We couldn't have imagined where the state of the art would be today with photorealistic digital humans in virtual sets.
To push the limits, once again, we decided to team up with Epic Games.
And now we are proud to bring you tonight's final world premiere at the Game Awards 2021! A glimpse of The Matrix Awakens and Unreal Engine 5. Experience.
Hi, I'm Thomas Anderson. Like many of you, I work with computers. But computers are also mirrors, reflecting back who and what we are and the choices we make, the worlds we build.
Still got it.
Like riding a bike, they say.
Oh yeah, it's playable. Everything you just saw is running in real time in Unreal Engine 5 on PlayStation 5 and Xbox Series X and S. It is pretty mind-blowing. And now you can download and experience The Matrix Awakens for yourself for free right now in its entirety. It's available right now. Make sure to play it. It is mind-blowing. Epic is just taking things to another level. Play it tonight, please. As we look to the future of games with platforms like Unreal Engine 5, it's now time to celebrate the best games of this year. To present Game of the Year, please welcome last year's winner of Game of the Year and Best Game Direction from Naughty Dog, Neil Druckmann.
Thanks, Jeff. Man, it feels awesome to be back here together in person. Congratulations to everyone who managed to release a game this year. Perseverance, dedication, and passion are inspiring, and there's no shortage of that in this room. Now, performing music from each of tonight's Game of the Year nominees, once again, the Game Awards Orchestra. That was fantastic. A fitting way to honor the very best of the year. Let's hear it one more time for the Game Awards Orchestra. And finally, congratulations to all of tonight's nominees. All pretty incredible games. And the 2021 Game of the Year is... It Takes Two.
So unreal, this thing. I was up in the that stage, 2017, saying fuck the Oscar, and now actually, in a way, the Oscars got fucked because the Game Awards is getting way better. So I know there are 30 seconds. I'm going to be extremely fast. So I want to thank my beautiful team for a fantastic work. Obviously, without them, I can't do anything. And also, I want to give this award to my daughter, Mio, and my soon-to-come daughter, Zoe. It's so nice to have children. I'm surprised how much you love them. If you don't have children, go get them. I mean, this is the best thing that can happen. Thank you again. I'm shaking. Look at me, man. This is like a big, big moment for me. And Neil, you're a big inspiration. Thank you. Thank you.
Congratulations. Joseph Ferris, so amazing. All right, what did you think of the winners tonight? Did your favorite game win? If not, post your thoughts with a YouTube short and let us know who got shorted tonight. Thank you again for watching the Game Awards. We'll see you next summer for Summer Game Fest. Such a pleasure that we got to do this in person. Thank you so much. Have a great holiday season. Good night, everybody.
Se acabó, no puede ser. Quería más anuncios. Y no anunciaron Bloodborne para PC. No hay Bloodborne para PC. Rayos. Se acabó. ¿Y ahora qué? Dios, ya son las 10. Tengo que irme a dormir. Dios, se acabó esto. Dios, pues estuvieron bastante brutales, más que el año pasado. No hubo tanto anuncio. Fue más... más a puro... un señor trailer.
There's a first look gameplay event. Head to rumbleverse.com.
Rayos, pues brutal esa mierda. 3 horas, Dios. Oh, el tiempo sigue avanzando. Tengo que irme a dormir. Vale, pues no sé, lo subiré. Sé que no sé en el dibujo. No mucho, pero ahí está. No lo puedo enseñar porque... eran prácticas. Bueno. A ver, termina esta mierda. Vale, todo correctamente. Dios, pues estuvo brutal, pero jugó buenísimo. Me voy a pasar a dormir.